Good evening and welcome to Verdict. Tonight, Lalit Modi is now virtually isolated with his biggest backer, Sharad Pawar, doing a shift. The master political strategist was left with virtually no choice after he was presented, our sources tell us, with IT findings on Lalit Modi at a meeting today with the finance minister and the home minister. And as allegations grew over family involvement of NCP ministers, both Praful Patel and Sharad Pawar's daughter denied any truth to what Praful Patel called a slander campaign. So as politics continues, our focus on Verdict tonight is what happens to Lalit Modi's billion-dollar baby. Can it survive without him? Will it, as his detractors say, will it actually get better? Let's just see what our panel has to say. My special guest tonight, Dean Jones, former Australian cricketer, one of the greatest one-day cricketers that we know. Also with me, Chetan Chauhan, Vice President of the Delhi District Cricket Association, Pradeep Magazine, Advisor Sports of the Hindustan Times. I'm also joined from London by Patrick Kidd, Cricket Editor of the Times, and Mandira Bedi, someone who's been part of, well, the whole IPL cricketainment as well and doing a great job on ITV of the UK this year. So are the fates of Modi and IPL linked? Can the IPL survive without Lalit Modi? SMS us, India space yes or India space no to 56388. You can also log on to ndtv.com or write to me at ndtv.com/Sonia. Well, let's go across to my special panel now. Pradeep Magazine, you've been following IPL since its inception. Can it survive without Lalit Modi?
Well, if it can't survive without Lalit Modi, that means the whole concept of IPL was based on an individual's efforts.
So, wasn't it? I mean, it was in a way.
No, if you go, see, ICL, Subhash Chandra ZTV started an Indian cricket league, which was based, which had 8 teams, which did successfully, despite the fact that the Indian board did not want anyone to play there. Mm-hmm. They hired the domestic cricketers, they hired outside cricketers. What I'm saying is that the model for IPL was there. What Lalit Modi did and did it wonderfully well was that within a short period of time, because they felt threatened by ICL, he kind of conceived and implemented and executed something within a short period of time and got in so much of money. But IPL as such, or any cricket tournament or any sporting event, cannot be dependent on one man, howsoever brilliant and outstanding he may be. Mm-hmm. If it is dependent on one man's abilities, then that means that if that man goes and the whole thing collapses, I don't think that that's possible.
Dean Jones, you were associated briefly with ICL. When people looked at what happened with IPL, and they actually compared it with what was eventually a damn squib. The difference was actually credited to a man like Lalit Modi, who more than just cricket brought in the glamour, brought in the Bollywood stars, made it something that around the world people wanted to emulate, or other cricket boards wanted to emulate.
Yeah, he's done a very good lot. The ICL had 8 teams, IPL had 8 teams. We picked 18 players per squad. They picked 18 players, but we picked 5 international players. So there's a little bit of the sameness going on. But good luck to him. He's made it bigger and better. Sure, he's followed the letter to the law, to the brief. And he's done a very, very good job. He's brought attention to India. He's brought attention to the franchisees, to the teams. And he's built it up to be the 6th biggest sporting entity in the world to inside 3 years, which is an amazing job. Now, his job is to make the brands bigger, smarter, faster and richer. Mm-hmm. And he's done that. And sure, you're going to stand on a few toes and maybe move the rules a little bit. But he's always said right from the start, my books are open, come in and see me, and go through anything you like. Now, here's the call. Is any of the sponsors missed out? Have they come through and said, we've got a problem with Lalit Modi? Have any of the people who've missed out through bids on franchises, have they said anything? No. I don't quite get the point. Why is someone going after Lalit Modi? That's the problem.
You feel it's a bit motivated.
It certainly is. And look, without his input, we wouldn't have the IPL be at its level it is. But someone will always take over. He might have something to do in 2 years' time anyway. Mm-hmm. But the game is, if he moved out now or on the 26th has been reported, will it get bigger and better? It will, because he set a great foundation. But the biggest point I can't believe is it's scurrilous, it's mischievous, it's malicious, the rumour mongering that's going on said about him.
Right.
Sources said this, it is rubbish. We have not got one bit of concrete evidence to say he's going to be sacked. And I think that's rude. Until that comes out as a proper thing from the BCCI, you cannot comment on it.
Tubar.com.